Many thanks for sticking with us here on Joy News Prime. Now, some victims of the devastating tidal waves in the Volta region are set to be permanently relocated. Residents in the Ketu South municipality in particular were displaced following the tidal waves that swept away their homes. Watch this.
In my house, this is my house. I, from here to the seashore is about 1,500 meters when I was very young. Yeah, 1,500 meters from the sea when I was very young. But up to this time, you cannot see the sea from here. It's about 30 meters.
Formerly, the town is not here. Fuma community is not here. But through the tidal waves of the sea, that is why we came here. Formerly, we used block to build our houses. But at now, we are using the coconut branches to build our house.
Effective teaching can go on when we combine, let's say, from KG1 to GHS3. We cannot do any effective teaching. So we are only attending to the GHS3 for now.
There were five in a boat, and the four left earlier. Then he followed later, reaching the seashore where the tidal wave have created another channel joining the River Volta. He's trying to cross over that small channel. At the process of crossing, then he drowned.
Physically, about 20 steps away in the school.
Yeah.
And that's how close the sea has come to the facility. Now, if you look at what it is, and we are not able to improve upon it, to lose it, the thought alone makes my heart just shudder. I cringe when I think about it. We must continue this intervention. We have to fix it. And Honorable Asenso came and assured us that it will be done. Yeah. So I don't even want to entertain that thought, that because the end of it is exposing the people to what is happening, then we should fold our arms and throw it up, our hands up in despair.
The Development Authority has also sent engineers for assessment, and they are also ready to replace broken down infrastructure. So in the medium term, that will be done. But the DC has made arrangement for the school children in the meantime. So in the medium term, the buildings, the school block will be rebuilt. But they are worried because this is not the first time they are rebuilding the school block. But I can see that they have a coastal development authority structure that is uncompleted. We work on that to get it roofed for them as soon as possible.
Well, months down the line, nothing significant seems to have happened. The regional minister was hauled before parliament today, and Archibald Letsa revealed that government has secured a service land to permanently resettle the victims. Parliamentary correspondent Kwiku Asante reports.
Victims of this disaster have been lamenting government neglect, but it appears they may get some permanent relief from government. Volta regional minister Archibald Letsa told parliament the first phase of the resettlement will begin next year.
The Volta Regional Community Council and the Ketu South Municipal Assembly have been working with the relevant state institutions and agencies such as the National Disaster Management Organization and the Ghana Refugee Board to help relocate and resettle all displaced persons of tidal waves in the Ketu South municipality or constituency. The Municipal Assembly has initiated the construction of 15 number two-bedroom apartments at Salakope to resettle about 150 victims of tidal waves in the municipality. The project is expected to be completed by the end of the second quarter in 2023.
He, however, explained that not all the victims can be relocated in the first phase.
Mr. Speaker, we managed to secure some funding through the lobbying of the Municipal Assembly, and with our good selves, we secured about 2 million cedis to start the first phase of the resettlement program. Mr. Speaker, I admit that the first phase will not be able to accommodate all the displaced victims. because we had about 1,096 displaced individuals, made up of 227 adult males, 287 adult females.
So this matter involving the tidal wave victims in the Volta region, as you may be well aware, became a matter of political footballing between the NPP and the NDC, with the minority accusing government of neglecting the Volta region and the victims of the tidal waves. Indeed, at the time, there were those who said that the tidal waves were due to some sand-wading activities in the region. At the time, government allocated about 10 million Ghana cedis for feasibility studies on the Blekusu Coastal Development Project, which was meant to stem this tide. Indeed, MP for the area, Abla Jifagomashi, in whose name this question stood, has been on a crusade to get government to act immediately. For Joy News, Kweku Asante, Parliament House, Accra.